Hey, good afternoon. I'm here with Cletus McDaniel, I believe.
Cletus McDaniels, that's right.
And he's from the great state of Texas.
Texas! Woo!
Okay. As I was saying, he's from over there in Texas. And apparently you have some Scottish heritage. Is that right?
That's right. My great granddaddy was Scottish.
Really? So was mine. How about that? Maybe they knew each other.
Maybe.
Maybe. Did your great granddaddy have a big orange beard and walk with a kind of a limp?
I reckon he did.
I never knew anybody like that.
No.
We're here anyway. Cletus came over because he wanted to go haggis hunting. Now, we'll put up a picture of the haggis and some various things for you to see. This is what we're intending to do. We're going to try and find, to see if we can find one of these wee haggises, or haggai, as it's properly termed, plural. So first of all, Cletus, we're going to have to get you dressed up. So we have to have the official haggis hunting hat. So that's some good alliteration for you, if you use alliteration in Texas. I don't know. But haggis,
what?
Haggis hunting hat.
Haggis.
Well, first of all, we use the old Scottish method, which is using a net. Do you know any Annettes?
No.
This is Annette, not Annette. No, she's my auntie. But what we used to do is we used to go out in the hill. Now, if you'll notice from the picture, the haggis only has two legs, a long leg on the front and a short leg behind him. And so what he would do is that way he could, with that, he could look straight out in the hillside because that long leg would obviously carry, so it wouldn't fall over. So, and they only run around the hillside clockwise. So what we used to do is we used to get in and we used to jump out on them when they were running around the hillside. And that meant that they would turn around and have to run the other way. And because of the imbalance in their legs, they would fall down the hill and we would just scoop them up with a net. Now that's the old way.
All right.
Now there's a way that I quite like, and that is getting our claymore out. This is a good one. Now, it's the same kind of method. You jump out on them. But what you do is you skewer the haggis right through and then slide it down to the bottom and you get about three or four haggai on your blade. And what's really good then is you can just set that on your barbecue and just rotisserie haggis is one of the nicest, daintiest meats you'll have.
Does it taste like barbecue?
I'm sure it would if you put enough sauce on it.
Right.
And of course, I think the one that you're going to like, Cletus, I'm sure that you're going to like the American method.
That's what I'm talking about right there. I'll tell you what.
So we take, we'll try the American method first of all and see what we can come up with. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Let's get her dead.
Get her dead. Well, Cletus, here we are in the woods down in the borders of Jevra. Now, what we'd like to do is we can try some of the bait for haggis. And unfortunately, it's very hard to get a hold of haggis pea to bait things. So we try and use the old cooking apple, or personal favourite, iron brew, which is made from girders in Scotland, of course, because pretty much everything was invented in Scotland.
Right.
So we're going to bait this and see if it catches the wild haggis.
One, two.
He went in here.
Right. Let's see. What do you think we'll do?
Well, it's just like a crawfish, man. You stick your hand out there and grab the sucker.
Well, I don't think I'm going to do that, but if you'd like to...
Let the Texan take care of this part.
Okay.
You hold my rifle there, bud. You hold my rifle. All right. You see, you just reach your hand right up there like this. He got my finger, but man, we got that darn haggis.
Yeah,
and we had some good eating.
And when we field dress him, we'll find your finger.
Aye.